So our new paper describes two mammals from the Isle of Skye, mainly their skulls that we're focusing on at the moment, and they're called Borealestes. Now, the first specimen was found in 1973 by Michael Waldman and Robert Savage. And Michael Waldman was actually the person who discovered this site, and he discovered the first vertebrates on the Isle of Skye. Our paper describes that specimen, but then it also describes this new one that we found in 2018. It was my colleague Richard Butler who found it. And when we got it back, we thought at first that it was the same species as the original one found in the 70s, but we were only able to really examine the two specimens using x-rays and CT scans. And when we did, we realised that we actually had a new species, so it was really exciting.
On this day, I was crawling over a wave cut platform that I've prospected for fossils many times before, so I really wasn't expecting to find anything. All of a sudden, I see this amazing, this beautifully preserved, tiny jaw fragments, just about a centimeter in length, with these amazingly preserved teeth. It's a hugely exciting moment because I knew right away that this was potentially the most significant fossil I'd ever discovered personally, and also that there was potentially much more of the animal in the rock than was exposed at the surface.
If you were to see Borealestes in real life, it would have been small, it would have fit in the palm of your hand, looked maybe a little bit like a mouse with a long tail covered in fur. It wouldn't have had any external ear flaps though, like we do, because they hadn't appeared in mammals by that time. These are giving us basically the blueprint for mammal success in the future.